How many of you own your good looks, your likeness, your voice? How many of you own your artificial intelligence? You look puzzled. Perhaps you didn't know your intelligence has already been digitized and nobody even asked for your permission. This challenge to our intellectual autonomy is being posed by something called generative AI. It's a class of artificial intelligence that can generate new and original content based on patterns and examples from existing data. So entirely new material, new poems, new music, new movies, new business documents, new legal briefs. I mean, many of you have used ChatGPT, DALL-E, Bard, Midjourney, you know what I'm talking about, right? So I'm really fascinated by the pace of progress here. You know, I was one of those kids who had a computer growing up. When I was 14, I got my first computer. I grew up programming. I built expert systems and old kind of artificial intelligence when I was in college. As an NYU professor, I've spent my career helping governments and companies navigate the complex digital space and shape new technology policy. So generative AI fills me with wonder, but it also makes me worry. Because generative AI is also able to generate and create in a way that mimics a specific person. That's right, someone can create your digital twin. Remember in the early days of Napster how we could create perfect copies and share music over the internet? Today we're not just sharing music, we're sharing musicians. We're not just downloading art, we're downloading actual artists, their creative process, their innovativeness, their talent, their originality. It's as if we've taken away the ability to own how we create, commoditizing our intelligence. So some of you might say, I'm not an artist, I'm not a musician, I have no literary talent, I have no literary ability, you're all very talented, don't worry. I have no literary ambition. So I don't need to worry. Maybe you do. I'm sure you've noticed how your social media feed is getting more and more customized and tailored to you each day. That's because it is being vetted and trained and tested on your digital twin, your AI. This AI is trained on every click, every purchase, how fast and slow you scroll, whether you stop and linger, your heartbeat captured by your smartwatch, every glance at your smartphone. Sensors keep abounding. These signals will grow richer. You know they will. And as they do, your digital twin gets more sophisticated and nuanced, an increasingly perfect replica of you. And that's just today. Tomorrow, your employer may create an AI version of you, your digital twin at work, trained on all your Slack messages, email messages, you know, business documents. You might actually start using this digital twin initially to draft memos in your own voice, reply to emails. Your twin might cover for you when you're on vacation, you know, a chatbot version of you to answer colleagues' questions. All sounds great. But if you wanted to switch employers, who's to say that your digital twin isn't going to stay behind? Or maybe even compete with you for that job that you're trying to get? This is very unsettling, right? Don't worry, there is a solution. We just need new laws that give us default ownership over our intelligence. You must own any artificial intelligence created specifically to replicate parts of you. And you must have some ownership claims over material that this AI replica of you generates. So we're at a point in time where governments are scrambling around the world to create generative AI policy. The sense of urgency is palpable. China, the EU, the United States. Here's what we need to tell them is an essential part of any responsible AI policy. To reclaim ownership of our digital selves, certain uses of artificial intelligence, creating deepfakes, using a likeness or voice without permission, unauthorized creation of digital twins, these uses simply have to be illegal. There is no technological solution. Now, to implement and enforce AI policy like this, we need three additional building blocks. One, known cloud infrastructure for high-risk AI. Know your cloud, a new kind of KYC. Two, tech company guardrails that align AI usage with societal values, reducing misinformation, hate speech, bias. Three, a powerful oversight agency that interprets existing laws and policies within the AI context. I mean, is copyright law enough in this particular situation? Do we need new policy? So let's imagine a future in which responsible and effective AI policy is in place. Here's what it might look like. An unauthorized likeness of yourself, you click on a browser button that says report unauthorized likeness. When browsing the web or social media, you've checked on a box that says do not use my data to train an AI. An artist sees a cartoon in their style that they didn't draw. The cartoon gets taken down. The artist submits examples of their work to a do not train service, sort of like do not call in the United States. At the end of a job interview, the hiring manager says, and of course, according to the new AI laws, any digital twin of yours will be deleted if you ever leave our company. So here's the reality. We're talking endlessly about artificial intelligence, and it's really important that we continue this conversation. But we have to move beyond the question, will AI wipe out humanity? Because the real question isn't whether artificial intelligence will surpass human intelligence at some point. It probably will. The real question is, how do we retain our intellectual autonomy in the face of this inevitable artificial intelligence ascendance? The answer, you have to have default property rights over your intelligence. 400 years of free market capitalism has taught us that without strong, robust property rights, we don't really have a successful free market capitalism system. So the next 3 years are going to be crucial in how we shape the future and stake our claim on our intelligence, our identity, our humanity. During this time, be mindful about how you are using other people's digitized intelligence. Push the norms in the right direction. Choose ethical AI products and services the way I'm sure some of you have chosen to use sustainable products and services. Keep an eye on the permissions you're giving AI services. Stay engaged in the public policy debate. That's really important. Because humanity is at a pivotal moment. We can design a world in which human intelligence and artificial intelligence coexist in harmony, giving us space for our creativity to thrive. We just need to retain our ownership over the most important intellectual property there is, our intelligence. Thank you.